This lecture introduces the concept of sampling distribution. Recall that the main purpose of statistics is to infer the population based on a sample. Because a sample is only a portion of the whole population, it is expected that there exists some difference between a sample quantity and the corresponding population characteristic. The error resulting from using a sample to estimate a population characteristic is called sampling error. For example, the IRS publishes annual figures on individual income tax returns. For the year 2010, the IRS reported that mean tax of individual income tax returns was 11,266. Here, the IRS reported the mean tax of a sample of 308,946 individual income tax returns from a total of more than 130 million of such returns. The population contains all individual income tax returns for the year 2010. The variable of interest is the amount of individual tax return. The reported number is a sample mean X-bar. It is expected that X-bar is close to the population mean mu. However, usually the sample mean cannot be exactly equal to the population mean. The difference between the sample mean and the population mean in this problem is referred to as sampling error. We need some tools to assess the magnitude of the sampling error, because we want to know how accurate the estimate is. This is why we need the concept of sampling distribution. For variable x and a given sample size, the distribution of the variable x bar is called the sampling distribution of the sample mean. Sometimes, we may simply call it the distribution of x bar. Use the diagram on the slide for a demonstration. Suppose we have a population. We draw a sample of size n, and we can calculate the sample mean based on this sample. We can draw a different sample of size n, and we can calculate another sample mean. Because these two samples are different, the two sample means are expected to be different. If we continue the procedures, draw a sample and then calculate the sample mean, we will get many sample means. You can see that these sample means are random. They may have a distribution. This distribution is called the sampling distribution of X bar. Notice that the sampling distribution of X bar is related to, but usually different from, the distribution of the population. Let's illustrate the sampling distribution of the sample mean using a concrete example. Suppose that the population of interest consists of the 5 players on a men's basketball team. We call them A, B, C, D, E. Their heights are listed in the slide. We can calculate the population mean of heights. Add the 5 numbers together and divide it by 5. The population mean is 80 inches. Now, let's consider samples of different sizes. Here, we claim 2 properties. Firstly, the sample mean X bar spreads around the population mean mu. Secondly, the larger the sample size, the closer the sample mean X bar to the population mean mu on average. Let me explain what I mean here. Consider drawing a sample of size 2. There are 10 possible such samples. In the first table, I list all the 10 possible samples. The sample mean is calculated for each sample. We can see that the sample means range from 77 inches to 83.5 inches. The dot plot shows the values of the sample means. We can see that it spread around 80 inches. Note that 80 is the population mean. Then consider samples of size 4. There are 5 different such samples. In the second table, we can calculate the sample mean for each sample. In the dot plot, we can find that the dots also spread around 80, the population mean. Generally, no matter what the sample size is, the sample mean x bar spreads around the population mean mu. Now, let's check the variability of x bar. Compare the two dot plots. It is clearly to observe that the dots in the second plot are more concentrated around 80. It indicates that as the sample size increases, the variability of the sample means decreases. To better illustrate the point, here we consider samples of different sizes. The 5 dot plots show the value of sample means for different sample sizes. For the first one, the sample size is 1. Here, one sample simply contains one player. Then we have samples of size 2, 3, 4, and 5. For the last one, the sample size is 5. We simply choose all players in the population. The value 80 is marked in the plot. It is the value of the population mean. For each plot, dots are around 80, which indicates that the sample means are around the population mean. As n increases, the variability of the sample means becomes smaller. The larger the sample size, the smaller the sampling error tends to be in estimating the population mean by a sample mean. It gives us a heuristic that in order to get better accuracy in estimating the population mean, the larger the sample size, the better.